Oh, here's another big surprise for you. So thistle. Now I have these two thistles on my little front path here because they're like my big guard dogs and no one wants to walk through my thistles. But they are incredibly edible. The entire plant is edible. The root, which is bigger than a parsnip, all of these leaves, which the best thing to do is you take one and you hold it over the fires to burn off all these little spikes. Unless you want to just roll it up like this, spike first, and then all the spikes in, and you can grab this whole thing. Once you've rolled it up from the base, you break it off, you can put it in your mouth all rolled up, and you can chew that whole thing, if you're game. Or you can get a pitchfork, and you get right down in there, lever it up, and you've got that big root. But what we're waiting for at the moment, because this one is in a position that is between a rock and the concrete floor, I can't get that out. So what I'm waiting for is for it to zoom on up and send up a big old stalk here. And then I'm going to cut that stalk off and use it like celery. And with the other one further back around, we're going to let that little one go to flower. And that flower is purple. And you can use that fresh as chewing gum, or you let that dry and you can boil that and you can make non-animal rennet. So that's vegetable rennet. So you can use that to make cheese. So for all you folks that don't like the animal cruelty side of things, and neither do I, because I don't like the way that normal calf rennet is extracted from the stomach of a recently slaughtered baby cow. I prefer to use the thistle flower. Now, here's an interesting little thing about thistle flowers too, is that the inner field of cows, one plant that they never seem to eat is the thistle. So it's almost as if the cow is telling you, don't kill my baby, don't rip out the rennet from its stomach, here's this thistle flower here for you to use instead.